standing in the early morning mist, night fog being swallowed by dawn, just motionless, me at cypress knees, watching the doe deer across the way step ever delicately to the water's edge, separated by black bayou and dancing reeds. To this place come do I, at first light often, engulfed in the swamp's solitude majesty. So it was on this slow sun warming moment that I did hear the earth speaking to me. Melodious like rush, a spring morn breeze, yet of authority and anguish that is so great. And I, transfixed, felt stings of its language. Quit poking me in the rocks of my bones, pleaded earth. Stop sucking my rich nectar and leave unmolested my subterranean core. I'm trying to be patient and tolerant, I am. But you invading viciously my dark, damp dirt. You dig into my complex, abundant domain and plunder my juices for your greedy gain. I could not pinpoint the source of divorce, a complaint that seemed to be all-inclusive. From the spears of the purple iris and the border oaks, from honking crows lazily circling high above, from the turtles arrayed upon a fallen branch, the earth speaking of its arrays of miracles, but I, motionless as the lamenting, did continue. You lay waste my carefully arrayed trees, earth said, plowed them down with abandon, and recklessly ignore my cultivated design, violate my grasses with smothering cement. Do you need to render asunder that green grove to build another cluster of shopping sites? How many must you have just to buy a pair of shoes? I felt the scorn of troubled earth invade me. Earth said, I try to curb my anger as you poke and pry, digging deep holes to fracture my skeletal rocks. But come, friends, can't we together find a better way? You may think I'm a moot, dumb chunk of old stone, and you can invade, ravage, reap my spoils without caution. But we are bound intrinsically indeed, you and me. Thus I ask politely, do not lay waste to my streams and rivers.